I'm Nell Freudenberger in Mumbai with Kiara Goya, working on a story about the dwindling population of the Parsi community here. We're here in the Dadar colony, which is one of the largest concentrations of Parsis in the world. You would never know walking around here that the population in India has dipped close to 60,000, and many of the people who live here aren't aware how dire the demographic predictions are. So the word Parsi refers to the descendants of a group of followers of the Bronze Age prophet Zarathustra, who came from what is today Iran to the west coast of India in the middle of the 10th century. They were looking for religious freedom as well as economic opportunity. There's a famous story that you hear repeated all the time about the Dastur, or high priest of this group, who had to ask permission of the Hindu king Yadav Rana to settle in Gujarat. The king wasn't sure whether he would allow them to make their home there, and so the Dastur asked for a bowl of milk. Depending on who you talk to, it was either a gold ring or a spoon of sugar that he put into the milk to demonstrate that the Parsis would enrich their adopted community without overcrowding it. I think this story is repeated so often because it's been so much the case for this community. They've remained small wealth while becoming extremely influential. The problem is the total fertility rate. One child or childless families are common, and 30% of Parsis remain unmarried. There's no stigma to being unmarried among Parsis, and if a brother or sister doesn't marry, they'll often live with their unmarried sibling for the rest of their life. 10 years ago, the governing body of the community, the Bombay Parsi Panchayat, started working with a doctor named Anahita Pandol. They set up a fertility clinic in South Bombay, which offers in vitro fertilization as well as other advanced fertility treatments. Since the program started, there have been 230 live births, and in January, the government of India contributed 10 crore rupees, or about $320,000, to the program. It might seem incredible that the government of India would give money to one of its wealthiest communities for fertility treatments when the total population of India is over 1.23 billion people. But the program has been surprisingly uncontroversial, maybe because Parsis are so beloved in the city. The most explosive issue in the community is that of intermarriage. Men can marry non-Parsis and still take advantage of all the benefits that the Bombay Parsi Panchayat controls, housing and other programs, including Geo-Parsi. But if a woman marries outside the community, she's not eligible for any of these benefits. The issue is especially emotional because the children of Parsi mothers and non-Parsi fathers are not traditionally allowed to be initiated into the faith or to enter the community's agiaries or fire temples. They're also not counted as members of the increasingly small population. The other night we went to a karaoke night sponsored by Zing, which is the youth group of the Bombay Parsi Panchayat. We spoke to one of the organizers who's also setting up an online matchmaking service. The youth wing will actually pay for dates for Parsis who are going out with Parsis in order to facilitate marriage inside the community. Parsis are known for being eccentric. We met a young man yesterday who has the cockpit of an Air India plane in his living room, and also for their sense of humor. At a new cafe here at Dadar, we met a couple. The woman told us that she had done her duty by having two children. When a visitor mentioned that every Parsi of reproductive age would have to have three children in order to reverse the downward population trend, she looked at her husband and said, "We're getting a dog. Does that count?"